that thing's in G, right?
Yeah.
Let's listen to it. I wouldn't mind listening to it.
The back beat is where the
Dave,
two
you, you gotta definitely say when to go to A and...
Oh, okay.
Eight times.
I'm just guessing, let me tell you.
Something in there.
Okay, whenever you guys are ready, just get one take and be good on this.
The studio that we've built over the last few years, this recording paradise.
The studio we love being at, love working at.
What's up, Butch?
I think it just really made us feel homey.
Yes, yes, yes.
This band is like my second family.
What's up, man?
How's the birthday party, man?
Oh, Lord.
The thing that has made us a family almost is we can go away from each other and you come back and you're...
Yeah! Do it again!
You know, in the beginning, we spent a lot of time together in that 15-passenger van going around the country, you know, 10 months out of the year.
The five of us got together to play music. I mean, we found each other and we started playing music together. And it's from the music that we became friends.
You lazy ass.
He's not in circles in a second.
We don't necessarily go out, you know, bowling with each other every Saturday night, you know, like we did maybe, you know, in the early days. But we definitely, when we come together to play music, you know, yeah, we are a family.
I'm there for the music. It's what we know of each other the most.
When we get together, beautiful things happen. That brings us back.
We're all brothers, we're all cousins, we're in this together, and when we get to the studio, it's just, I mean, it's, you know, it's magical.
We like make beautiful things together, consistently. That's what I think. And we're getting better at it, holy moly. What's the chances?
When opportunity came to be involved to work with Dave Matthews Band, so I was overjoyed, like, wow, that's incredible, you know, to actually be considered to even work with a band of that caliber.
Let's make it just a love festival.
The first time we heard about Mark, I think it was through John Alasia, and he just was really impressed with Mark. He worked with him a little bit in a studio.
When I walk into a room, you know, it's not about me at that point. I've shed myself at that point.
It was a different experience, a different technique. Carter sat down and played just one of his infinite number of smoking licks. And then Mark, because he's got ears like an elephant, not actually, but you know, he has big ears. Just loved it, so he kind of looped a section of it for us to work with. So I sat down and wrote the lyrics to the song.
I believe in love, we'll save us all. I believe that,
yeah, something like that. It could be that, or it could be dark, you know. But I like that. Stand up. Yeah, it could be dark.
My goal with Dave Matthews Band was to make an album that was different than any other album they ever made.
I like the first line. It's got a God thing. So I woke up with the angels singing in my head.
The way it worked in the past a lot is that at least finishing the lyrics is the thing that happens at the end when all the music's done. But whereas when we were working here, the lyrics were an integral part of the process.
Tomorrow night, we could start humming or babbling on. On some songs just to get some melody out by tomorrow.
I have absolutely no fear.
Cool. Neither do
He's
I.
A king. When I'm writing lyrics, I try to leave it as ambiguous as possible.
I like Shoot You Up Again.
I like that shit.
It's somewhere between sex and being saved.
I like that concept.
The way that Mark was doing it, it got me off of that sort of panicked ending that I often have had. On record, where I was like, you know, what am I going to say here? What are the lyrics going to be for this song?
To stand up, to stand up, y'all, stand up, I never leave.
what the context of the song is. And so Carter and Roy and everyone can react to the words.
Man, but I don't know what to do with these kind of tunes. These tunes is just totally inspiration. You gotta really, for the moment. Stand
up, stand up. Now, you know, Boyd can just play a couple lines on the violin.
It happened so quickly, just a couple bars, you know, and 5 minutes later, it's turned into a whole piece.
It's a plus for us to have somebody on our side, like Mark, to get that creative side flowing.
It felt like the beginning of the band again, you know? It felt like that time again when we were just like, just getting together, you know, just like one-on-one, working out parts together.
I like to think that every album is a new chapter.
There's just a lot of cool musical avenues coming up. So, I mean, it's all good.
Finding that musical, you know, connection, you know, one-on-one again, it was so much fun. Mark Batson, from the minute I met him, has definitely been one of the coolest guys, you know, I met in the music business, you know, period. He's a great musician. He plays everything.
That shit is me, man.
He plays keyboards, he plays bass, he plays guitar. He understands music inside and out.
You got that. It's like the second half of it.
You know, all these guys write their own music. I'm just looking for whatever can be great in that person. You know, I'm just kind of just trying to get in their lane, walk in their shoes.
Yeah, keep doing it.
My initial thought was, I wonder what it sounds like when they play on their own.
In the beginning, he brought us in each one at a time. I came in, you know, he said, hey, how you doing? What's going on? Talked a little bit. And they say, you know, you got your violin? I say, yeah, right here. He said, okay. Press record. And he said, play.
That's great, man. That's great. Hold that for me. That's a song right there. Yeah. Got something from that.
When I could look at him and see, you know, his body react to that part and how he felt about it, I was like, that's it right there.
What came out at that moment was the main riff of the song, American Baby.
This shit, please. Kick is like, kick him.
You know, being from Brooklyn, to have started out in a rap group, working with rappers, I mean, it's always been about, you know, looking through crates and crates of records to just find that one loop or that four bars that just hits everybody, and then people take that, deliver that pieces, and they build songs from it.
We never really worked with a producer with his type of background before. We'd mostly worked with rock producers.
He brings his experience, which is primarily in hip-hop, so from a sampling perspective, he brought that into a room of people that have been glued together for a long time. So now it's sort of, he's like sampling us. He gets excited because, you know, he hears me play something on the guitar. I'm just messing around, but he's like, well, that's the beginning of a whole song.
Nice when the bass starts in, if it goes on, you know,
for the chorus.
Yeah, it fits to a perfect part where.
So what we're gonna do? We're gonna find like toward that part where I started dipping the bass into the dum dum. We're gonna find a good one that got everything in it, and we're gonna make that into the chorus.
There are little gems flying around all the time, and Mark caught all of them. If somebody comes up with a little two-measure phrase or some little thing, he'll remember it, he'll grab it, put it in the sampler and keep it around, and then later bring it out and start to build something out of it.
It wound up being a very therapeutic process, kind of like group therapy. Ooh,
I'm afraid we've lost the way he stays.
Shit, that was nice. It's just up there, and my first one of the day. Forgive me, sir.
The main part of it, the initial process, is for that person to feel like they're ready to be free, like they're ready to share. And then once that happens, you kind of could just get out the way.
I hope you stay American, baby.
We already feel that we're already close, and we get closer all the time, you know, as brothers, you know. But Mark's way of working has definitely made us come closer together musically. I think it's a really cool way to work. It opens up the doors for us to be more creative and to learn more things about ourselves. If I do a solo, for instance, and Mark records it, I listen to that, I study it, and then I create something out of that.
On this record, Carter got a chance to be really expressive and do what he's most famous for, which is just spin the whole thing up and drive drummers insane.
That beat and nudity go close together.
Mark, he just kind of opened the doors for the Matthews Band. So we got a new thing happening here, and I think it's going to work, you know, from here on out.
Nobody's laughing now. God's grace lost and the devil is
when the bass and the drums and the guitar were layered on, I was like, oh my God, I can't believe what happened to that riff I came in with that on that day, you know.
I hold on to you, you.
Mark worked very quickly. I felt like every single day there was a new tune that he was like all excited about. Every day I walked in there was something new going on.
Yeah.
This is one of my favorite licks in the history of all music. Sting, 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 sting
asshole.
Some musicians are just so talented and genius, they can just pick up somebody else's instrument and just start to play. I see that the guys in this group are guys that have those type of natural gifts. Carter might play drums, but then, you know, Carter might jump on the piano.
When you're in a studio setting, it makes you want to walk around and try different instruments. And, you know, one day, you know, I might, like, jump on the drum kit just to, like, try it out.
You get a butt shot?
Yeah.
But Stefan, you know, I'm sure, you know, he's going to be able to play some guitar. He's going to be able to play some piano. He's going to be able to create with a number of different instruments and a number of different environments.
They're all calling, play me, no, play me. And the basses are always just like, go ahead, go play the keyboard, whatever. We know you're going to play us later. Go on, go play the keyboard. Types of music, but I really found a love for heavy bands like Nirvana and Tool and Nine Inch Nails and heavy bands. I mean, I listen to as heavy as you can bring it.
That's too much rock for one hand.
Everything. Because this section's got to be slid to put it on the Pro Tools grid.
Too much rock for one hand. Everything's
in a real grid.
So just one day, it was just like, okay, let's try the guitar next and see what happens.
I don't know. I rock pretty hard. Chicks all dig the bass player. I'll take it. So then Mark's like, get the guitar on, man. Just let's just jam with the guitar. Just get the guitar. So I went over and picked up the guitar and
came in there, did his thing. I'm going for the great light. There you go.
When he started playing on the guitar, the whole grunge thing that he was feeling was coming out in the guitar. You know, Stefan laid the foundation,
And all you have to do is just stand up there and just go for it. And that's right up my alley.
Next thing I know, we were grooving. I told Mark that day, I said, this has to be about dirty sex. Just gotta be. Whatever Dave writes on top, you know, just whatever your lyrics are, just make them dirty.
Here you go, you dirty girl. Good God.
Bondi just laid that down, and then we built a song on top of that. A lot of that stuff went on. I'd sing over something, and then someone would put a bridge on it. It allowed us to be sort of separate and then see each other in a different light.
That diversity and that differentness of where we come from musically just really works well together as a group.
The band is much stronger than it used to be in a lot of ways because of that.
It's like some Peter Gunn shit.
This band is a finely tuned car. This car, everyone wants to drive it. Everyone looks at it when it passes by. Like, the car is just incredible. I would have to say Carter is like the engine. Always fine-tuned. And it always runs, sounds good.
Carter is the most incredible musician I think I've ever met.
Carter, there was one time that you did a fill that was almost like made it feel like halftime. It was just really cool the way that it just put this whole moving feel to it.
I think I'm the frame.
Stefan's the youngest member of the band, but in some ways the most mature member of the band too.
Stefan has a knack for making you feel certain things when he plays.
Dave's guitar playing is such an integral part of our sound. So the guitar is sort of like the wheels. Like, you need the wheels or the car is not going to go anywhere. I think his vocals would be the interior.
That's what I miss. Music has that thing to make people pat their foot, you know, rock their head, you know. And Dave, through his vocals on this particular album, he really worked that to the T.
Boy Tinsley is just another way to spell love.
Leroy and Boyd are easy. They're all the details. They're the fine details.
Hey!
Roy is like the old spirit guy, you know? What he brings in the band is like just the soul of it.
This record is it's just the beginning of, you know, what can happen.
These guys rediscovered themselves, and then at the end, that's what this album wound up being. Just this great discovery. One got to speak in their own voice. Bring that meme back in
me again. Some of our fans, most of whom I think are enormously clever people, there may be some of them that have a very strong opinion of what we should or shouldn't do, and they might find parts of this album they might not think appropriate for our band. And then one of the songs is going to come on, and they're going to be grooving out, and then they're suddenly going to realize that it's the new record that they were, and then they're gonna have to just, you know, they did, and it'll be like almost like a rebirth for those people. This is a good record. You know, I can sing like this if you want to. Oh. I like when this shit sounds unnatural. Not like when it sounds like, you know, the you part of it I like.
You, but you know who needs you.
Mm-hmm. I'm not saying that I'm Don Juan. I'm very, you know, I'm a reasonable looking guy.
What are we doing now?
Gooby dooby old dirt hill, rada da da da.
We're making some damn cop music over here.
Booby doo boo boo. Dream girl coming up and getting my thing.
This is a classic fucking album.
Yeah. Scooby fucking dooby.
A feel good record for the summertime.
We have to do all the other stuff again? I can't remember all the genius. The incredible genius that I laid down into the system.
It's one of the days I remember. But you know?
Sounds fucking incredible. It's life changing.
So
that was some weak shit right there. Do we got it?